students, myself Meenal Deshpande. How are you? Hope so, you all are fine. Students, in our previous video, I taught you lesson number 3, the Harappan civilization. We took information about 4 points. 3.1, the Harappan civilization. 3.2, housing and town planning. 3.3, seals and ports. 3.4, the Great Bath. Do you remember? Okay. In this video, I am going to teach you remaining 3 points. Point number 3.5, life in the Harappan civilization. 3.6, trade. 3.7, reasons for decline of the Harappan civilization. Now we are going to see the next point. 3.5. Now we are going to take information about the occupations of Harappan people, their crops, clothes, ornaments, arts, etc. 3.5. Life in the Harappa civilization. Already we know that the people from Harappan civilization are very skillful in agriculture, means they are practiced agriculture. The excavation at Kalibangan provides evidence of a plucked field. What is meant by evidence? Evidence means witness. Okay, means when excavation began at Kalibangan, at that time they got some witnesses of the plucked field. The people there grow different crops. Now which crops were grown by them? See, mainly wheat and barley. Means wheat and barley were the main crops. In Rajasthan, barley was grown on a large scale, while in Gujarat, it was ragi. See, in Gujarat, ragi was the main crop. Now peas, sesam and lentils were also cultivated by them. The Harappan people were also familiar with cotton. Means with these all crops, the cotton crop was also taken by the people. Now the statues, the pictures on the seals and the remains of a clothes found in the excavations indicate that the Harappan people used to weave cloth. Now, whatever remains they got, from that remains, we can understood that the peoples are engaged in weaving the cloth. Means clothes which were used by them, that was weaved by them. The dress of both. Now men and women, both are consisted of knee-length cloth and upper garment also. Now many types of ornaments have been found in excavations. Now in excavation we got some ornaments, and from that we can understood that which type of ornaments were used by them. They are made up of gold, copper, precious stones and as also shells, cowries, seeds, etc. Men and women both used multi-strand necklaces, rings, armlets and waistbands. See, the peoples used the gold, copper, precious stones for their ornaments, and women's wore bangles right up to their upper arms. A statue found at Harappan site presents an excellent specimen of their art. Now what is mean by specimen? Specimen means a sample. See how I'm going to show you one picture of the ornament. From that you can clear your idea that which type of ornaments used by the people. The same way, a statue which was found at Harappan site, which was a very excellent sample of their art also. It shows the man's facial features very clearly. Means whatever expressions are here, that are shown very properly in the statue. Now, a cloak with a beautiful trefoil pattern is draped across his shoulder. Now, what is meant by cloak? A cloak means a long outer garment worn over the shoulders covering the back. Now, in this picture, you can get proper idea. And what is meant by trefoil pattern? Trefoil pattern, it is a one symbol having a shape of such a leaves which is used as an architectural ornament. Okay, now see this picture, a specimen of Harappan art. Okay, see, now in this point number 3.5, we took information that which type of crop was taken by the people, which type of clothes wear by them, same way which type of ornaments were used by them, and about their art. Okay, now we are going to learn point number 3.6, that is trade. This is very important. See, the Harappan people carried on the trade within India and as well as other countries. See, they are trading with India, in our India also, and with the other side countries also. The Indus Valley was known for the high quality cotton. In Indus Valley, properly they are taking a crop of cotton, and that was a very high quality cotton. This cotton was exported to other regions. Now, like West Asia, Southern Europe and Egypt, they exported this cotton. Now, cotton cloth too was exported. Not only the cotton was exported by the people, but also the clothes which are made up by the cotton were also exported. Okay. Now, the traders of Harappan civilization provided muslin cloth to Egypt. Now, what is meant by muslin? Any of several varieties of thin cotton cloth. That is one type of cotton cloth. Okay. But that was good type of quality. Silver, zinc, gemstones, rubies, deodar wood were some of the items that were imported from Kashmir, South India, Iran, Afghanistan and Balochistan. Now, trade was carried on the both, means by land route and sea routes. Means the land route and sea route were used for the trade. Now, some of the excavated seals bear pictures of ships. A huge dockyard has been discovered at Lothal. Now, what is meant by dockyard? A dockyard means a place where ships are repaired or outfitted. Okay. Now, that place which is at Lothal, that was a very, we can say that is the example of big dockyard. The trade of the Harappan civilization was carried on along the coastline of the Arabian Sea. See, now in this point, we took information about the trade of Harappan people. What was exported, imported by them, that also. Okay, now the main point or the last point from the lesson, that is 3.7. Reasons for decline of the Harappan civilization. Now, what is meant by decline? Decline means to cause, to decrease or diminish. Or in our language, we can say to become weaker. Why this Harappan civilization become a very weaker? See, there are some reasons. Which reasons are there? The first and very important reason, that is frequent flood. See, frequent means again and again. That time, again and again, the flood situation was created over there. And that is why the Harappan civilization get a bad damage. Second reason, that is invasions by foreign tribes. Invasions means the objective of conquering the territory or established the government. Means if enemies who want to capture that region, they are attacking on the country or that region, that is known as invasion, and by the foreign tribes. That is the second reason. And the third reason, that is a decline in a trade, were some of the reason for the decline of the Harappan civilization. Almost the trade was or trade were also decline at that time. So these three reasons are, we can say this, because of these three reasons, the Harappan civilization declined. Now, the Harappan civilization or some reasons from that becomes arid. Arid means very dry due to weakening of monsoon. Because of weak monsoon, at that time the regions become arid. Drying up of river basins, earthquakes, changes in sea level, that are also some reasons. Now people migrated to other places, leading to the decline of cities. The peoples also went from one place to another place. That is known as a migration. And that is also the one reason for the decline of the Harappan civilization. Okay, now see, we can say that this Harappan civilization, the remains of the excavated town indicate excellent town planning. The agriculture and the trade were their main occupation. The good produced in the Harappan settlements were exported outside India. So, after seeing this all, we can say that the Harappan civilization was a prosperous and flourishing urban civilization, and we can say that is laid the foundation of the Indian civilization. Okay, means this Harappan civilization was very popular, very flourished, very prosperous, and it's laid the foundation, we can say that is the base of our Indian civilization. Okay, do you understood?
You have to write the answers of the following questions in your notebook. In our next video, I will teach you the next lesson. Thank you.